What really happened on Easter? Well, I'll tell you. The Bible tells us very clearly in 1 Timothy chapter 2 that Jesus gave himself in ransom for all of us. What we often overlook is, who did he give himself in ransom to? Not to God. God was already on our corner. God already has sent Jesus into the world. God has loved us when we were yet sinners. You know what? Jesus gave himself in ransom to the one who had us captive, the devil. And actually, he executed a monumental, if I may say so, Hail Mary pass. He faked to the left, swung to the right, and threw a pass that the devil could never catch. Where do I get that? In the book of Colossians, chapter 2, verse 15, it says that the devil and his principalities and power had a weapon called the act of the decrees that was contrary to us. And I imagine that he was trying to torment Jesus by telling him and showing him that weapon and saying, you are dying alone. I cannot touch you because you are holy. But everybody else, from Adam all the way to your mother, they are on this act of the decrees. It's contrary to them. They have sinned, and the soul that sins will surely die. And Jesus is hanging there on the cross, and the devil is circling the cross with that weapon, saying, you are dying alone. And then at one moment, Jesus lifts up his eyes and cries out, my God, why have you forsaken me? And then the devil chose that moment to close in, and he didn't realize that Jesus was waiting for him, because Colossians 2:15 says he took the weapon away, nailed it to the cross, wrote on it with his own blood, forgiven, and he gave us life through his death. I can imagine the devil shouting, you can't do that, you can't do that, it's against the rules. And I'd like to imagine God speaking from the heavens and saying,
I just changed the rules.
And the devil saying, I want a replay. I mean, what rule is that? It's called grace. How come I never heard about it? Because it was hidden in my son's blood, waiting for you to lance his body. And when the blood of the sinless one was shed on behalf of all the sinners, at that moment, I, a holy God, can embrace them because of Christ's righteousness. Yes, my friend, Jesus gave himself in ransom for you and me, and not only he paid the price, he exposed the principalities and powers as totally, totally disarmed. And today, on this Easter day, you can lift up your eyes and see Jesus saying, it is done. Your sins are forgiven. Just receive the Lord and enjoy the freedom that he bought at the cross.